Hello everyone, this is Anshu Jain from Qatar Day, and today we are going to be talking in detail about the labor mobility in Qatar. That is the key information for employers and employees. All workers in the state of Qatar can change jobs without having to obtain a no objection certificate anytime during their contract period. While the removal of the NOC covers all workers, the rules to end an employment contract and change jobs differ for different categories of workers. These changes mark a major milestone in Qatar's labor reform agenda and transition towards a knowledge-based economy as set out in Vision 2030. Now, what do these changes mean in practice? All workers in Qatar, whether on fixed-term contracts or open-ended contracts, no longer need to obtain a no-objection certificate or NOC to change employers. This means that, as an employer, you can now more easily recruit workers locally with the skills and local experience needed for the job. Now, how will these legislative changes benefit you as an employer? The new laws will lead to better job matching, where employers can recruit workers with the right skills to carry out the task and previous experience in Qatar. Decrease in recruitment and repatriation cost through local recruitment. Increased job satisfaction, leading to higher retention of workers. Now let's talk first with the workers' perspective. That is, for private sector workers covered by the Labour Law No. 14 of 2004. What procedures does a worker have to follow if he or she wants to change employer? A worker wishing to change employer must notify the current employer that he or she plans to terminate the employment contract through the Administrative Development Labour and Social Affairs electronic system. Please make a note that all the communication is going to be happening via the Administrative Development Labour and Social Affairs electronic system. The direct communication between the employer and the employee will no longer be considered valid. The worker must work until the end of his or her notice period. If the worker has worked with the employer for 2 years or less, the notice period is going to be of 1 month. And if the worker has worked with the employer for more than 2 years, the notice period is going to be of 2 months. Now, what happens if a worker does not honor the notice period? That means the worker is not willing to serve the notice period. If a worker terminates his or her contract without observing the notice period, he or she must pay the employer a compensation equivalent to his or her basic wage for the notice period or the remaining part of the notice period. And this is calculated as an amount equivalent to the basic wage for the remaining part of the notice period. For example, if the worker's basic wage is Qatari riyals 1500 per month and the worker stops working 2 weeks before the end of a 1 month notice period, he or she will have to pay to the employer Qatari riyals 750 to terminate the contract legally. Now, can a worker change jobs during the probation period? That means the worker is willing to change the job while still he or she is in the probation period. It may be stipulated in the employment contract that the worker shall be subject to a probation period agreed upon by both parties, provided that the probation period does not exceed 6 months from the date of commencement of the work. The worker shall not be subject to more than one probation period with the same employer. A worker may terminate the employment contract within the probation period as well, provided he or she complies with the following. He or she must notify the current employer at least 1 month before he or she leaves the job through the Administrative Development Labour and Social Affairs electronic system, and the worker's new employer must compensate the current employer a portion of the recruitment fees and one-way air ticket at the level that was agreed to by the current and new employers, not exceeding 2 months of your current basic wage. The compensation amount should be discussed between the new and the old employer. Now, during the probation period, what are the procedures that workers have to follow to terminate their employment contract and leave the country? That means leave Qatar. If the worker leaves Qatar without giving a notification or completing the notice period during the probation period, the worker will not be able to return to work in Qatar for 1 year. And in order to avoid the situation, the worker needs to follow the below procedures. The worker should notify the employer through the Administrative Development Labor and Social Affairs electronic system. And the notice period should be agreed upon with the worker but cannot be more than 2 months. Now, after the probation period, what are the procedures that workers have to follow to terminate their employment contract and leave Qatar? That means you have fulfilled your probation period, you have now entered into the normal contract, and now you're willing to leave the country by leaving the job. If the worker leaves Qatar without giving a notification or completing the notice period, the worker will not be able to return to work in Qatar for 1 year in this case as well. In order to avoid the situation, the worker needs to follow the following procedures. The worker should notify the employer through the Administrative Development Labor and Social Affairs electronic system, and the worker should work during the notice period, which cannot be more than 1 month if the worker has worked for 2 years or less, and 2 months if the worker has worked for more than 2 years. Now, what happens if the employment contract contains a non-compete clause? Employers should refrain from using non-compete clauses except in specific situations where the nature of the work puts the worker in a position to know the clients of the employer or the secrets of the business. This means that after the contract termination, the worker cannot compete with you or take part in any of the competing business in the same economic sector. The duration of the non-compete clause cannot exceed 1 year from the date of contract termination. Now, if a worker leaves the company, does the employer still have to pay the end of service gratuity or other benefits? If the worker completed at least 1 year of employment and the contract was not terminated for committing any of the violations described in Article 61 of the Labour Law, the employer must still pay the worker his or her end of service benefits, accrued annual leave not taken, and any of the benefits stipulated by Labour Law No. 14 of 2004 and the signed employment contract. Remember that the employer must also continue to provide food and accommodation or the relevant allowances until the termination date. Now let's talk with the perspective of the employers. What procedures do I have to follow as an employer to terminate the employment contract of a worker? After the probation period, an employer wishing to terminate the employment contract of a worker must notify the worker that he or she plans to terminate the employment contract through the Administrative Development Labor and Social Affairs electronic system. If the worker has worked with the employer for 2 years or less, the notice period is going to be for 1 month. And if the worker has worked with the employer for more than 2 years, the notice period is going to be of 2 months. The employer should continue to pay the wage and other benefits to the worker during the notice period as per the employment contract. Now, can an employer terminate the employment contract of a worker immediately without observing the notice period? That means the employer does not want the worker to serve the notice period. If the employer terminates the contract without observing the notice period, he or she must pay the worker a compensation equivalent to the worker's basic wage for the notice period or the remaining duration of the notice period. This is calculated as an amount equivalent to the basic wage for the remaining part of the notice period. For example, if the worker's basic wage is Qatari riyals 1500 per month and the employer asks the worker to stop working 2 weeks before the end of a 1 month notice period, the employer will have to pay to the worker Qatari riyal 750 to terminate the contract legally. Now, can an employer terminate the employment contract of a worker during the probation period? An employer may terminate the employment contract of a worker during the probation period as well, if the employer finds out that the worker is unfit to carry out his or her duties. The employer must notify the worker at least 1 month before the termination through the Administrative Development Labor and Social Affairs electronic system. And upon termination of the employment contract, if the worker is going back to his or her country, the employer must cover the expenses of the return plane ticket. Now, during the probation period, can an employer terminate the employment contract of a worker without observing the notice period? If the employer asks the worker to stop working before the end of the notice period, the employer shall pay the worker for every day of the notice period the employer asks the worker not to work for. This is calculated as an amount equivalent to the basic wage for the remaining part of the notice period. For example, if the worker's basic wage is Qatari riyals 1500 per month and the employer asks the worker to stop working 2 weeks before the end of a 1 month notice period, the employer will have to pay to the worker Qatari riyals 750 to terminate the contract legally. Does an employer have to pay for the return flight ticket of the worker upon termination? The employer must complete the worker's repatriation procedures, including bearing the cost of a return air ticket to his or her country of residence within a maximum of 2 weeks from contract expiration. And if the worker joins another employer before leaving the country, the repatriation obligation shall be incumbent upon the new employer. In cases where the worker terminates the employment contract prior to its end and plans to leave Qatar while respecting the notice period, outside of the scope of amended Article 51 of the Labour Law, the employer shall cover part of the cost of the return air ticket proportional to the actual employment duration the worker completed out of the full term of the employment contract. Now, what procedures does a new employer have to follow to locally recruit a worker? Once the change of employer, which is requested by the worker, is approved by the Administrative Development, Labour and Social Affairs electronic system, the employer will receive a confirmation SMS from the concerned authority. The employer is then responsible for filling the information of the employment contract with the new worker through the Administrative Development, Labour and Social Affairs digital authentication system for a multilingual employment contract. After filling the information, the employer should print the employment contract to be signed by himself or herself and the worker, and then will upload the signed copy with the other required documents onto the digital platform. Upon the concerned authority's confirmation that the employment contract has been authenticated, the employer must pay the fees for contract authentication and print the authenticated employment contract, which will be automatically sent to the Ministry of Interior's program for ID issuance purposes. He or she must provide a copy of the authenticated employment contract to the worker as well. The employer should log into the Ministry of Interior's Metrash Services webpage to request for a new Qatari ID, that is QID card, for the worker. Once the QID procedure is completed, the employer should provide the new QID and the health card to the new worker. Now, who pays for the administrative procedure required to change employer? The administrative procedure required to change the employer is free of charge for workers. The employer should pay Qatari riyal 60 to authenticate the newly signed employment contract. Now let's talk about the workers who are covered by these special laws. What are the rules on termination of employment for domestic workers? The rules for terminating and changing jobs for domestic workers are the same as for the workers covered by Labour Law No. 14 of 2004. An updated standard employment contract for domestic workers reflecting those rules is forthcoming, which we will be sharing with you very soon. However, remember that the probation period for domestic workers cannot exceed 3 months, and that a domestic worker can only have one probation period with the same employer. In addition, domestic workers may terminate their employment contract anytime during the contract period without notice and keeping their right to an end of service gratuity pro rata, annual leave dues, as well as a return plane ticket back to his or her country of origin in cases specified by Article 17 of Law No. 15 of 2017 on domestic workers. At the same time, employers of domestic workers may terminate the employment contract without notice and without granting end of service gratuity for the year of dismissal if the domestic workers does not abide by the obligations as stipulated in the employment contract or those described in Article 16 and 11 of the Law No. 15 of 2017 on domestic workers. Now, what are the rules to terminate and change jobs for agricultural and grazing workers and fishermen? The rules for terminating and changing jobs for agricultural and grazing workers as well as fishermen are exactly the same as for the private sector workers covered by the Labour Law No. 14 of 2004. And if you need to know more details, check the Council of Ministries Resolution No. 17 of 2012 on the application of some provisions of the Labour Law No. 14 of 2004 to workers in agriculture and grazing. Now, where can I find more information? For more information, please contact the Ministry of Administrative Development, Labour and Social Affairs on the hotline number 16008, or you can send an email info@adlsa.gov.qa, or you can visit their website, that is www.adlsa.gov.qa, or you can contact Qatar Day. And for more such updates, keep following Qatar Day on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. At the same time, subscribe to our YouTube channel, that is Qatar Day. And keep visiting our website for daily news and updates, that is qatarday.com. Thank you.